Rockies have already taken the field. Leading off will be Marvin Bernard, followed by Bill Miller. Batting third will be Barry Bonds. Jeff Kent, the cleanup hitter. He's been hot over his last nine games. Joe Carter will hit fifth. He, too, over his last nine games, has been smoking. Then it's J.T. Snow hitting sixth. Rich Aurelius, seventh. Brian Johnson will bat eighth, and pitching and batting ninth is Kirk Rueter.
On the mound for the Rockies today will be right-hander Jamey Wright, who's got a 90-plus mile-an-hour fastball, which has a good sink to it. He'll throw a curveball. Now, he used to have a slider, but he's gone to a more Coors-filled, friendly breaking ball. That's the over-the-top curveball. And where he gets into trouble is when he gets a little too fine on his first pitch and he falls behind the count. For him to be successful, he's got to stay ahead in the count. Behind him defensively, the Rockies will have Bichette, Hamilton, and Walker in the outfield with Castillo, Perez, Lansing, and Helton in the infield. Former Giant Kurt Manwaring will be behind the plate, getting the assignment to do the catching. And youngster, 23-year-old Jamey Wright on the hill. There's Kirk Rueter with a good game face. Game faces are easy to find today in the Giants clubhouse before the game. Very determined bunch, this Giants team, and they know what's at stake here, Kai.
Indeed they do. And this is what you play for. You play for a game in which everything is on the line. And the Giants will be watching the scoreboard in Chicago. Also, well, the game is in Houston, but against Chicago, and also the scoreboard in Atlanta. So Marvin Bernard gets ready to step in and face Jamey Wright. Bernard hitting 322, three home runs, 35 RBIs. Marvin 1-for-8 lifetime against Wright, and the first pitch of the game is a strike.
Well, Jamey Wright has one of those arms that is dangerous. It's unpredictable. He's young. He doesn't have great command of his stuff yet, but he has good movement. And if he can keep that in the strike zone, he would present a problem for the Giants. A 92 to 94 mile an hour sink is what he has, and that can be a nasty pitch. When he's on, he'll throw a lot of ground balls.
And the 1-1 delivery to Marvin Bernard, and Marvin takes it low and in. Bill Miller on deck, followed by Bonds. Bernard in the series, 4-for-8. Had a couple of hits yesterday. And he hits one off his fist. Vinny Castilla will make the play. One down.
Wright got deep in Bernard's kitchen with that fastball. Broke his bat. It's the old line of the clubhouse or the dugout. When a guy pops up like that, a guy said, you read that sporting news, or do you hit with it?
Makes just an awful sound when you hit a ball where Bernard just did. Miller with a 295 average, 9 home runs, 59 RBIs. He did not start the game yesterday, and he takes a pitch out of the strike zone. He played on Friday night, went 2-for-5. Miller 3-for-7 against Jamey Wright. And it's low and away 2-0.
If you watch Jamey Wright, he really reminds me a lot, stuff-wise, of William Van Landingham. Giants fans remember that the thing that made Van Landingham special when he first came up was that he had unpredictable movement on his fastball. Sometimes it would sink and run away from a lefty. Other times it would run flat into a right-hander. Sometimes it would back up and go straight. And he can be a tough opponent because of that unpredictableness.
Well, after throwing well to Bernard, Wright on three pitches falls behind 3-0. Miller trying to get on base, so Wright will have to pitch out of the stretch to Bonds. And Miller takes ball four.
Not close.
Yeah. It goes back to what you said, Mike. He's just unpredictable. You don't know what you're going to get from hitter to hitter.
And he's not easy to catch either. Kurt Manwaring will have his hands full. Oftentimes you'll see him set inside with a target and then the ball go across the plate to the other side.
Bonds has had little success against Wright. He's only 2-for-14. Bonds went 1-for-6 on Friday, came back and went 3-for-4 yesterday. And he swings and fouls it back on a fastball 0-1.
I think it helps a veteran team. If anything, I believe the Giants have an advantage today because they just saw Jamey Wright not too long ago in San Francisco, so they're familiar with his stuff, and I think that is a disadvantage to a young pitcher. You because they are at times a little one-dimensional as to how they try and get hitters out. And if he's predictable in that, in what he'll throw in certain pitch counts, I think that'll favor a veteran club like the Giants. They'll sit on pitch or location. And that's when they can hurt him.
Miller with his lead. And Bonds just gets out of the way. Perez playing Bonds to pull. He's nearly behind second base. And, of course, way off the line at third is Vinny Castillo. Bonds hit a double down the left field line in his start yesterday. Low. 2-1. Bonds did a good job yesterday against Daryl Kyle.
I think that was the whole key to the game, the way they adjusted to him and went off opposite way, and that's how they beat him.
2-1 pitch to Bonds is low, 3-1.
Another thing, the more patience you can have against a young pitcher who's struggling like Wright is now, the better chance he'll dig his own hole.
Miller at first, 3-1 count. Bonds rolls it foul, and now it's a full count. And a good chance Miller will be gone. Jeff Kent waiting on deck. The Giants won 8-6 on Friday, 8-4 yesterday. Both games, they pounded out 15 hits. Three and two. Go to first, Miller back.
With Jamey Wright, you won't see a lot of dramatic catching targets from Kurt Manwaring. He'll pretty much sit behind the plate. He'll corner locate his glove on occasions, but basically he's just going to give a center target and let Wright's unpredictable movement just run his course.
Mets have scored a run in the seventh inning. It's now 5-2, Atlanta leading. Dennis Martinez is pitching for the Braves after Maddox had started. Cubs leading 1-0 in the third, and Manwaring's going to go out and have a talk with Wright.
Well, he's run through the signs about four times, and I don't think he's got that many pitches. I think Kirk's thinking, well, maybe this guy wants to invent something out here. I better check.
Bond's actually kind of disgusted with the whole thing as he stands and waits.
Bonds has been very quiet throughout this weekend. Been very focused.
3-2. Miller goes. Bonds, ground ball. Lansing has got it. And he'll throw him out. So Lansing, who is shading Bonds to pull, makes the play.
Now he makes a fine play going to his left, gets on his belly to rob Bonds of a hit, which would have set up a first and third situation for Kent.
Kent yesterday in the first inning knocked in Bonds from first base with a double. He is 3-for-7 against Jamey Wright and batting .298 overall with 125 RBIs. Pitches way out of the strike zone. One ball and no strikes.
I'm watching Mike Lansing, the second baseman for the Rockies, play throughout this series. He takes a pretty big cheat step. When he comes in and gets his feet planted in position and ready to make a play, he has a pretty strong lead either left or right, depending on where the location call was. And he's been burned by it a couple times in the series, but that last time, that cheat step really helped him to get to that ball Bonds hit.
Kent fouls it back. One ball and one strike. Joe Carter on deck, just underway. Another gorgeous day here in Denver. We've had three in a row. Kent pops it up. Helton, Lansing. Helton makes the catch. And that'll end the inning. No runs, no hits. The Giants strand one. Bottom. bottom of the first coming up. Giants nothing, Rockies nothing. For the Colorado Rockies, their lineup brought to you by Southwest Airlines looks like this. Darrell Hamilton will bat first, followed by Nafee Perez. Hitting third is Larry Walker. Dante Bichette, the cleanup hitter, only 1-for-8 this series, followed by Vinny Castilla. 190 against Rueter. Todd Helton hitting sixth. Seventh, Mike Lansing. Kirk Rueter, eighth. Jamey Wright, ninth.
And on the hill for the Giants tonight, left-hander Kirk Rueter, who leads their staff and wins with 16. Very similar style to Daigle and Glavine of the Braves. He likes to establish the outside part of the plate early and then change speeds off of that, and he'll come in tight with a good hard fastball late in the count to right-handers to get strikeouts with.
Hamilton hitting 308 with six home runs, 51 RBIs. Takes the first pitch up and in. Hamilton 1-for-7 in the series. It was always great fun listening to Hamilton and Rueter on the airplane, chirping back and forth at each other. And here they are in opposite uniforms. Foul down the left field line.
And for Kirk Rueter, who has 16 wins, he only has 183 innings pitched. A lot of that is because he has not gone deep into too many ball games in his 32 starts. He's only gone seven or more innings six times in those 32 starts.
And now full count to Hamilton.
Part of those problems have been a very tender elbow that he's had since about halfway through August. But one thing you can say about Rueter, when he takes the mound, the Giants believe they're going to win. They have a lot of confidence in him.
Mark McGwire has just hit a home run for the Cardinals. 69. Payoff pitch to Hamilton. In on the ground. Aurelia's going to have to hurry. And they got him as Snow just stayed on the bag. One down.
Defensively for the Giants behind Rueter today, they'll have Bonds, Bernard, and Carter in the outfield with Miller, Aurelia, Kent, and Snow in the infield. And Brian Johnson will be doing the catching today. Kirk Rueter. Woody, as his teammates call him. Trying to spin another dandy for him. He's been outstanding in September's the last couple seasons. A perfect 7-0.
Nafee Perez, 1-for-10 lifetime against Rueter. Hitting 271. 8 home runs, 56 RBI. And that's a strike.
That's a strike that Rueter likes to get, that low outside corner. He can throw three pitches to that location. Change up, a sinker, and that big, slow, swivel slider.
Rueter got him. And Perez trying to bunt his way on, two down. 20 bunt hits this year for Perez, but not that time. And here's Larry Walker. Yeah, the National League batting race is all but over. Can we give it to Walker?
We're giving it to him today.
All right, let's do it. It is Walker in front of Olerud. Walker hitting 362. Olerud hitting 353. And he takes a strike.
Pretty remarkable accomplishment for Walker. As you see, the St. Louis score, noting the 69th homer of the year for McGwire. It's remarkable for Walker, Kai, because of the injuries he's had to battle through this season.
Well, it hasn't affected his average. It certainly has affected his RBIs with 66. Inside to Walker to make it 2-2.
It's really cut his power down. It's cut his stroke down. And because of the abbreviated swing, he's put a better average up.
Walker 2-for-12 lifetime against Rueter, and that just missed. Now a full count. Dante Bichette on deck. Over the mound in the center field, the base hit. Here's Dante Bichette. Bichette also having a terrific year, 331. 22 home runs, 122 RBIs. And Rueter tries to jam him, but he takes it inside 1-0. Bichette has had average success against Rueter, 6 for 22. Gets it on the ground to Aurelia. Aurelia will go to Kent to end the inning. A runner stranded for the Colorado Rockies. We've completed one inning. It's nothing, nothing, and Joe Carter will lead it off. Information regarding postseason Giants tickets, individual game tickets for a potential tiebreaker game on Tuesday the 29th for division series playoff games, which will take place Saturday and Sunday at 3:00, are now on sale. A tiebreaker game will be played in San Francisco on Tuesday. If the wildcard race ends in a three-way tie, Giants win the first tiebreaker game in New York on Monday. If the Giants win the wildcard race, then they host the division series next Saturday and Sunday on the 3rd and 4th at 3:00. 5-0-762-BALL. Joe Carter tips his cap, a standing ovation here at Coors Field. And Joe, you deserve it. You're one of the best in my book.
Amen. I just wish I got a chance to play with him. He has been something else since he's come over with the Giants. And I think there's a lot of other clubhouses that he's hung a uniform in that can say the same thing. And a pretty nice response here from the Colorado Rocky fans in his honor. That was super.
And he takes a strike. Carter hitting 289 in a Giants uniform with 27 home runs. And that pitch is low and away. Javier played yesterday. Carter did not, although Joe Carter did end up taking a swing as a pinch hitter. In the dirt. He picked up a hit and three at bats on Friday. Nothing, nothing, second inning. Balls and two strikes now to Joe Carter.
Last game of the season is really a very different game in a lot of ways, obviously because of what this game means to the Giants, but it also means that everybody, with the exception of possibly yesterday's starter, Earl Hershiser, everybody is eligible to come into this game. Because there really is no tomorrow. Dusty Baker has to play it that way. So Mark Gardner could find his way in this ball game, as well as Sean Estes, who was the pitcher who pitched Friday in the first game of the series.
So it's a full count to Joe Carter. The Astros have just tied the game up in Houston. It's 1-1 Chicago and Houston. Carter, a rocket into center field, a base hit. Hamilton knocks it down, and the Giants with their first hit, second base runner.
Pretty nasty pitch, too, from Jamey Wright down low in the strike zone with a lot of hair on it. Joe Carter is dialed in right now. He pinch hit yesterday, had a good at bat. He'll rocket to center field for an out. See him staying in, staying tight, and his bat speed has been outstanding.
JT Snow, 248 with 15 home runs, 78 RBIs. Carter with a lead. And Snow takes a strike. JT 1-for-5 on Friday. Had a couple of hits yesterday. And is 4-for-6 against Jamey Wright in his career. And he gets jammed, and Vinny Castillo will make the play. JT got jammed once yesterday just like that.
Boy, so far, Jamey Wright has done a great job to get in tight to the lefties. He's jammed Bernard, he's jammed Bonds, and he's jammed JT Snow. Ball getting right in there at 94 miles per hour. Good life. Looks like he's in a little second stage on that fastball, okay? But you're really now chalking it up. A couple of Jekyll and Hyde days, opened up the series with four hits, and then in yesterday's ball game had three strikeouts. Finally salvaged his afternoon with his hit in his last at bat, went 1-for-5.
Strike to Richard Rueter. Richard taking a walk out. Now we'll look down to Ron Wotus as Dusty Baker gives the sign to Wotus. Carter goes. Aurelia takes it. Here's the throw down to second. And it's not in time. And I have a feeling Rich Aurelia just missed the hit and run. And he's shaking his head to Dusty Baker as if to acknowledge, yeah, I know.
Now, irregardless, it was an outstanding job from Joe Carter. And young ball players who are watching this game today, watch the way that he slides into second base to avoid the tag. He takes his right leg and goes to the outside corner. And he avoids the swipe tag from Mike Lansing. And that is why he got the stolen base. If he goes the other side of the bag, he's out.
0-2 to Aurelia. Now he asks for time. On deck, Brian Johnson. There you see the tie score in Houston. Aurelia with a check swing foul into the charter seat area. Dusty Baker, very quiet in his office today.
I think the catch word today is just focus. They were all locked in.
Aurelia goes to right field. Walker's got a beat on it, and he'll make the play. Now let's check into our Fox Network Center for our Mark McGwire home run update.
This is a special report from Fox Sports News.
I'm Kevin Frazier. Mark McGwire has just hit his 69th home run.
Into left field. Back at the track at the wall. Historic number 69.
This has been a special report from Fox Sports News.
And back in Denver, they're going to walk Brian Johnson intentionally. 69 for Mark McGwire.
Just what? What else can you say about that guy? The year he's had, potentially walking Johnson, and Jamey Wright almost threw a ball back in the strike zone.
So Brian Johnson will take the walk. Rueter, who has hit the ball well this year, will have a chance to help his own cause in the Giants.
Talked to Don Bader, the skipper of the Rockies, the day before the game, and he said he's going to play like it's a playoff game as well. He's got his guys ready to play. There's some adrenaline going on both sides of the field. And they would like nothing more than to spoil chances for the Giants. And he mentioned he will play it like a one-game playoff, and that means that Pedro Estacio is going to probably be the first guy to come out of the bullpen for the Rockies today. Normally a starter, not today. He'll have the tennis shoes off and the toe plate on.
Rueter 14 for 64. Swings and misses, and he falls behind 0-1. Now, if Rueter, generally speaking, if he gets a hit, he's going to get it to left field, and that would be a matchup of Bichette trying to throw out Carter if he gets it to the outfield. Bichette is cheating in. Outside. Talking about Don Baylor on his pregame show on the radio here in Denver, he told Wayne Hagen that he did not think he would be back next year.
What a shocker coming from Rocky Skipper. I was surprised to hear that.
Here's the 1-1 to Rueter. Swinging a ground ball. He pulls it to Lansing. And that'll be the inning. The Giants will strand a pair. We'll head to the bottom of the second inning here in Denver. It's the Giants nothing, Rockies nothing.
Yards in Coors Field, the new Pacific Bell Park will be an experience to remember. An intimate 42,000-seat baseball-only ballpark with great sidelines from every seat. The charm of beautiful brick architecture reminiscent of the old-time parks and reflecting the style of the China Basin neighborhood. Breathtaking views of the Bay Bridge, the San Francisco skyline, and the water make for the most dramatic location in sports. And you can be a part of all of it. It's easy to do because there's just less than 300 charter seats. You got to try and do it now. That's right. Write N-O-W now. Call 1-800-5-GIANTS. With number again, 1-800-5-GIANTS.
And where we're located, you can see these charter seats very close by here at Cool School. Kirk Rueter, a little late start out of the dugout after he grounded out. Took his time. Let's see. The second level, that is the charter seat area, right level where you see the scoreboard. Wonderful view for a ball game. Vinny Castilla swings and misses. Castilla hitting 320. That's in the top 10 in the National League. 45 home runs in the top 5. 142 RBIs in the top 2 as he takes the pitch inside. One ball and one strike. Castilla was 1-for-5 on Friday, went 1-for-3 yesterday. He has played in every game this year. He's the only Rocky to do that is Bill Miller. Loves it, steps, throws, one down.
I don't think there's a better testimony to endurance for a guy to be able to hang in there for 162 games during a baseball season. Tip my hat, anybody could do that.
It is a grind that you really can only experience if you've tried to do it. That's why, you know, Cal Ripken Jr. is just not human. There's a line drive over the head of Rich Arruya. Bonds will cut it off, and Helton's got a one-out single. He can hit.
Well, that's moving well to his left to cut that ball off. You've got to take some straight routes to the balls here if you're going to gamble to try and cut a shot off that gets in the gap. It's got to be a pretty scary place if you're an outfielder. See how quickly this ball gets out. And the outfield grass, just like the infield grass, is cut short, and it's a very fast outfield. Bonds did a nice job to cut it off. Hold Helton to a single.
Here's Lansing. A rocket to right field. Carter is right there, and he'll make the catch. Lansing lines out. He's been the one guy the Giants have had a real tough time getting out in this series.
Had a pretty good second half. Miserable start for the Rockies. Press kind of got on Lansing here a bit. But he has salvaged his year, and he's basically put up what his lifetime average is in everything. Batting average, home runs, RBIs.
And Kurt Manwaring takes a strike. Manwaring is hitting 242, a couple of home runs, 26 RBIs. And he takes another strike. Terry Mulholland has just doubled in a pair of runs. And the Cubs are leading 3-1 in Houston. 0-2 to Manwaring. And that just missed.
Boy, has Mulholland had a great year for the Cubs or what?
Wow.
I mean, besides Sosa, he's got to be the second most valuable player on that team.
So Helton at first with two outs. Runner goes, a base hit for Manwaring, past Kent. Carter gets to it, and they will rush it back into the infield. First and third, two outs for Jamey Wright.
Well, the one thing nice about Kirk Rueter is that he's always around the plate, so he's the kind of pitcher that you can put a hit and run on. But I find it a little peculiar that they're hitting running with the eighth man in the lineup. Don Banner's certainly not predictable today. let it all out. This might, as you mentioned, Kai, be the last game he manages for the Rockies. So he's going to go down swinging.
Okay. Jamey Wright hitting 179. Got a home run, four RBIs. And a breaking ball is hit into center field for Marvin Bernard. And that will retire the side. A couple of runners stranded on two hits. We'll head to the third inning here in Denver. Nothing, nothing, top of the order coming up. Here in Denver, not a cloud in the sky. And Marvin Bernard will lead it off. Bernard, Miller, Bonds. Second time around now for Wright against these Giants. And Bernard takes a pitch that I'm not quite sure where it was. One ball and no strike.
Thank you very much. That was right there.
There's Dreckman behind home plate. 2-0. Wright had probably a good opportunity there for a pitch close to get the call, but the ball tailed way outside. And it's 3-0.
We're talking about no clouds in the sky. Wasn't it Ted Robinson who was telling us on Friday it was supposed to rain today?
It's going
to
rain.
Yeah, remind me to get on him when the game's over. Can't let that slip out.
We will have an opportunity to do that. Here's the 3-0 pitch to Bernard, and that's a strike.
I think he just evened up the first pitch.
That was, it didn't have to be, huh? Dusty on that top step. Wright with a 3-1 delivery. And Bernard takes high.
Jamey Wright taking a look into the home plate umpire, Bruce Dreckman. He's wondering where the heck the strike zone is. And I don't blame him. This is a 3-1 fastball that they set up for inside. Comes right back in where the target was. And I think Bernard may have ducked that one.
Chicago over Houston, fourth inning. Mulholland doubled in two runs to give them the lead. Here's Bill Miller. And Miller takes way outside. Miller walked in the first inning. Atlanta in the eighth inning leading New York. If the Cubs and Giants win, they'll play tomorrow in Wrigley. Snap throw, Bernard back.
Watch Wright's delivery. He really throws over a stiff front leg. And when you do that, you really put a little extra stress on your shoulder. Ideally, you want to have a little more drive and a little more bend in your front leg so that you can straighten that leg out and then torque your body. That's how you get velocity. He's got good velocity, but I don't think he really uses his legs as well as he could. And because of that, he overloads his arm a bit. I think if he's going to have problems with his arm down the road, it's going to be in his shoulder.
1-0 to Miller. Bernard drawing some attention. And Miller fouls it to the opposite field. One and one to Bill Miller. Mom and Dad still in town. They couldn't pick a better weekend to watch the Giants play. Everything on the line. Long hold by Wright, and it gets away from Manwaring, and there goes Bernard.
Well, we talked about it a bit yesterday, but the way you create that opportunity for yourself as a base runner is to get into a secondary lead with the anticipation that there's going to be a ball in the dirt or that it's not going to be received properly. When you identify with it, it gives you a quick reaction to it. Only if you anticipate do you get that kind of reaction. Marv Bernard does, and has an easy pitcher in the third base.
And Miller with the ground ball to the right side, and Bernard gets to third. Here's Bond.
Good baseball there by Billy Miller, getting the job done, getting Bernard over.
Infield will play in with Bonds at the plate. He hit a sharp ground ball to the left of Lansing that Lansing dove for and threw him out. Popped him up, but it'll be out of play. So Wright jumps out in front. Good job by Bill Miller.
Kyle, when you have a fast infield like they have here in Colorado, is it a concern of yours as an infielder when you have to come in and play up as the Rockies are for Bonds now?
Yeah, I think he played maybe a step or two deeper. Bonds hits it foul. And then squirts into the seats. And you know the ball's going to get to you so quick. That, I think of all the infielders, Todd Helton is the one that's doing it the most as they set up now. Normally that wouldn't be playing in. So right now going for the strikeout. A rocket, and that's a fair ball. Bernard will score. Bonds letting it out, and he is going to put on the brakes. Giants lead 1-0. And it came on an 0-2 pitch.
Bonds has the type of swing that can turn around an 0-2 pitch. He waits a long time, very quick, very short stroke. But just a big mistake from Jamey Wright to get beat in that count. And you can watch the location of the 0-2 pitch. It's just right out over the plate above the belt. That's got "hit me" written all over it, and Bonds does. He gets a cripple, and he delivers. Dusty Baker digging it.
Here's Kent. Popped out, and he pops this one foul down the right field line. He popped out to Todd Helton in the first inning. Bernard scores the first run of the game.
I think he got a little mad at himself. He got another hanging breaking ball. Right through the same curveball he threw Bonds, 0-2, and Kent fouled it back. Not happy with it.
Five for nine in the series. Kent hits one to center field. Hamilton going back. Still going back. At the track, at the wall, he makes the catch. And Bonds will tag and go to third. Check out Joe Carter and our BF Goodrich in the groove. Mighty Joe. See his numbers in the last 24 games. 7 for 11 in the Pirates series with 3 home runs. With 6 San Francisco home runs. 3 have given the Giants the lead. Carter had a line drive single in the second inning. If he does that here, he'll give the Giants another run.
That's the kind of leadership you want coming down the last few weeks of the season. You want the big boys to stand tall. He's done more than that.
Low and in to Joe Carter, 2-0. A.T. Snow on deck. Right with a 3-0 pitch. And Carter takes 3-0. Did I say 3-0 to make it 3-0? 2-0 pitch to make it 3-0.
Hey, you're excited. It's the last day. Come on.
Trying to figure out if he might be pitching around Joe Carter.
Give you a mulligan there. Well, they all know that Joe Carter's in heat. The kind of numbers he's been putting up, the whole league knows about it.
Carter with a green light fouls it. J.T. Snow would be the hitter if Carter were to get on base. And the 3-1 pitch, and Carter rolls it foul. The stolen base by Carter in the second inning was his 231st. I mean, this gives you an idea that Joe Carter, as a younger player, wasn't just a power throw. It's a 3-2 count and the pitch. And Carter hooks one to left field. Bichette going back, and it is out of here!
Unbelievable.
And Dusty Baker showing everyone how he did it. And the Giants fans are on their feet.
There may be a few Rockies fans in there as well. Appreciation for this great talent. Home run 396 on the career.
And the smile on the face of Joe Carter says it all. And here's JT Snow. JT Snow takes a strike.
That has been an unbelievable story.
Terrific. Mighty Joe Carter. Blowing away. And he really hooked it.
It wasn't really a bad pitch from Wright. He went down there and got it.
And it is very typical of the way Joe has swung his entire career. You know, he's savoring every minute of this game as Snow takes a strike.
Right, he says he's relaxed. He's enjoyed his last few weeks in the big leagues. And then today he has a chance. If things go the Giants' way, he'll have an opportunity to play in the postseason.
JT stays alive.
And I'm sure he's been asked over 1,000 times since his home run, the dramatic World Series victory when he beat the Phillies and Mitch Williams in the home run that ended the World Series in Game 6. He said, is that the best thing you could possibly do? He said, well, only one thing better, do it in Game 7.
Snow's got a base hit as he rifles one. Walker's going to try to cut it off. He goes down to a knee to do it. And a good strong throw. Snow is in there with a two-bagger. Now that's good baseball right there. Snow hustling all the way. Walker with a good play and a throw. I'm not sure it gets any better than that.
Well, the Rockies have come to play, and Larry Walker shows it on this effort to go in and try and make something out of what should have been a sure double. Slides into it, very quickly gets up and throws on a fly to Nathan Perez, but not a time to get JT Snow. Gold Glover in right field, putting on a show.
To go, Joe. Here's Rich Aurelia. Hit a line drive to Walker in the second. And that's inside, and Richie opened up, and that ball got by him. It's a home run.
Now you talk about hooking the swing. Here's how you do it. Pitch is down, out over the plate. Really not a bad location. Pitch 3-2. And he just goes back. And how strong do your wrists have to be to put a swing on like that? Baker obviously enjoying that one too.
That's our Bob Stevens replay. One ball and one strike.
Bill Carter loving life, and he should.
7 home runs for the Giants. Bill Carter. Rich Aurelia had 4 hits on Friday night. And yesterday he struck out in his first 3 at-bats. And with a kind of 0-2, Marvin Bernard got thrown out trying to steal. Eventually Richie came back and did get 1 hit. Ended up 1-for-5. High bounding ball to Perez. And Perez will throw in time to get Aurelia. And the Giants put 3 on the board. The big blow the home run off the bat of Joe Carter, and it's bye-bye, baby. 3-0 Giants. By Bonds. Giants lead 3-0. And here's Darrell Hamilton to lead it off. Hamilton facing Rueter for the first time in his career. Grounded out to short in the first inning. And he takes a strike on the inside corner. Fair ball. Miller dove for it. Hamilton is going to have a double. Right over the bag. Miller made a good effort.
How many times have we said it, though, that Darrell Hamilton, a left-handed hitter, at times swings the bat as if he's a right-handed pull hitter. It's a lot of balls on the left side of the field. Not surprising.
Sweet at bat for him. Here's Nathan Perez, who tried to bunt his way out in the first and popped out. And he hits a high fly ball to left field. Bonds moving back. Hamilton now is thinking about tagging. Bonds makes the catch and the throw. And Hamilton stands.
There's no money in trying to go to third base for Dale Hamilton down 3 runs.
So much for getting that guy over. And here's Larry Walker.
Nathan Perez, not a real disciplined swing at that ball. But they're not playing for 1 run, obviously. It's the way he went after that at bat.
Walker in this series, 4-for-6. Singled in the first inning. Hitting 364. Rueter misses one ball in those times. On deck, Bichette. 3-0 Giants. Bottom of the third. A little bit off the plate. 2-0.
Well, normally, if it was a one-run ball game or a tie game, Rueter would pitch carefully with an open first base, but I don't think he wants to get into a walk situation here and bring the tie and run up the plate with Dante Bichette, who's on deck. I think he's got a challenge here.
Swing on a miss. 2-1.
Goes to the breaking ball to 2-0 and gets Walker to swing through a pretty bad pitch. Sometimes I think Walker just decides he's going to go up there and swing at the pitch no matter what.
I agree with you. Walker, another bounding ball off the plate. Aurelia coming in. He will throw in time. Nice play by Rich Aurelia.
Well, I agree. I didn't think I had any chance when that ball came up high off of the home plate.
Here's Bichette, who grounded out to Aurelia in the first inning. Dante takes a peek at his bat. Good stretch. First pitch, and it's low and away. One ball in this time. Good crowd today. A few no-shows in the upper deck. Bichette hits a ground ball to Miller. Billy's got it. Sets. Throws. Side retired. Hamilton stranded at third. Fourth inning coming up. Giants on top. 3-0. Brian Johnson will lead it off. Giants on top, 3-0. Time now for Whatever It Takes, brought to you by Grand Auto Supply. Joe Carter hooks one. Down the left field line. Is it deep enough? Bichette going back. It is deep enough, and that's our Whatever It Takes. Grand Auto Supply. Brian Johnson with a count of one ball and no strike. Johnson hits a high drive to right field. Walker shading his eyes. And he makes the catch. You can't trust him.
You're right.
Walker shaded his eyes yesterday on a home run that Charlie Hayes hit 50 feet over his head.
He deked every broadcaster in the ballpark.
We were sitting at dinner last night, and the more we talked about it, the more angrier John Miller got.
John said he was talking about Walker before the play, and ex-MVP in the National League, a very good player. And afterwards, after he deked John, the conversation went to Larry Walker, who had a very disappointing year this year. That was pretty funny. But he did get all of us.
Rueter with a kind of 0-2. Way outside.
John Miller said, yeah, the broadcaster always gets the last word.
Marvin Bernard on deck. One out. Rueter into center field to Darrell Hamilton, his buddy. And that'll be out number two. And here's Bernard. Still 3-1 in Houston. Cubs leading. Eric Bell just hit a ball to the warning track in right field with two runners on, but was caught by Sammy Sosa. And that ball game in Atlanta. They are now in the ninth inning. Atlanta leading the Mets 7-2. Marvin takes a strike. Bernard has popped out to third, and he led off the third with a walk. The Giants scored three runs that inning, and the pitch is inside. Bill Miller would hit if Bernard keeps this inning going. And it's off the plate. Two balls and one strike. Wright standing on the mound now rocks and throws the 2-1 pitch, and it's low and away.
Just relying on sinker throughout the whole at bat here to Marvin. That's got a lot of confidence in that pitch. Whenever he gets back to the corner, that's what you're going to see. What the Rockies are trying to get him to do is develop an off-speed pitch to go along with that good movement on the sinker.
A walk.
Make him a little less predictable, especially in fastball counts. There's definitely room to grow, but hey, when you're 23, you're going to make a few mistakes. You don't figure to have all the answers when you're that young.
Bill Miller walked in the first, hit a ground ball to the right side in the third inning. And on the ground ball that enabled Bernard to go from second to third. Bernard then scored on Bonds' double. As Wright continued to keep Bernard close. 11 steals on the year for Bernard. Bonds waiting. Miller looking down to Ron Wotus.
Definitely a steal situation for Bernard. Time you have a two-out scenario for a leadoff hitter, and he's on first. That's the time to go.
Right now, Wright having a tough time at his release point. 1-0. If he misses, it always seems that he misses low and away or high up in a way.
Well, that's the shoulder drag I'm talking about. Because he's so stiff on his front side, he doesn't have great drive through his target. And when he drags that shoulder through, he starts to sling. And when you sling, your release point varies. It comes across your body, and it doesn't center on one location. And that's when you don't get good command.
Every night at 10, Fox Sports News Primetime delivers a complete live wrap-up of the day in sports. Check out Fox Sports News Primetime on Fox Sports Bay Area tonight at 10. Yeah. that is a strike to even the count. Rueter watching.
All Frank Funk did was tell Jamey Wright to slow things down a bit. Trying to be a little too quick on the man on first base out of the stretch. He defied the shoulder drag and got him back in a better throwing position by just slowing him down as he started home.
Two and one. And with a young pitcher, you'd almost like to have what they have in the NFL now. They get those walkie-talkies inside the helmets.
That's not a bad idea. You might see that in baseball.
Young pitcher have the pitching coach be able to talk to
him. You're always going to have that. Hitter in the batter's box is going to have something that's going to be able to intercept those codes in his helmet.
Miller hits a drive into right center field. Walker moving over. He'll make the catch. And that will end the inning. Bernard stranded. The Rockies coming up. 3-0 San Francisco. Rueter on the mound for the bottom of the fourth inning. He's given up four hits. The Rockies have stranded four, and here's Vinny Castilla, who led off the second by grounding out to Bill Miller, and he takes the pitch low, one ball and no strikes. And a fastball for a strike. Todd Helton on deck. 3-0 Giants. And that's out in front of the plate. Rueter. As it spins, throws, 1-1.
Good mixture of speeds there to get Castilla off balance. Boy, they really neutralized his bat throughout the series. 2-for-10 with just a couple of singles. That's saying something. An explosive Mr. Castilla.
There's Todd Helton, who hit a line drive over the head of Rich Aurelia in the second. Him up out of play over the backstop.
Kurt Manwaring before the game today gave a two thumbs up to the rookie Todd Helton. Likes his makeup and likes the way he works, the way he approaches the game, the respect that he has for the game and its history. So he's going to play this league a long time.
There's a strike. Well, it's hard to teach a short stroke. And this kid's got it. Tried to paint him and missed. One ball and two strikes.
It's not often you see him get off balance on a swing. I mean, even the first pitch of this AP, a big breaking ball that was slow, he was on it.
And he stays alive by popping it out of play.
He's using a little more pine tar, though. Watch the hack. Gets loaded very quickly, sets his hands up, and his cock position goes up about 6 inches from where he sets himself to start a swing.
One, two pitch. And Rueter came inside and missed 2-2.
That's where you have to get this guy, especially in the payoff situation. Right-handers can run something flat at the belt at him and let him go at him with a two-seamer inside.
Into the gap. Bonds giving chase, and he tracks it down. Two outs in the fourth.
Doesn't look like he goes up against left. He's trying to pull it all. I think he thinks left field. But still a good AP, especially in a two-strike situation.
Lansing lined out to Joe Carter in the second. Three home runs in a game. About 10 days ago in this park. One old pitch to Lansing. Two balls in no strike. Rueter has to come in. And Lansing hits a high fly ball to Bonds. Bonds going back. This ball's keeping on going. Bonds at the wall. Makes the catch. It just kept going. 3-0 Giants as we head to the fifth inning. Bonds, Kent, and Carter coming up. 3-0 Giants. Now let's go down to Glenn Kuiper, who has joined us, and he's next to the Giants dugout.
All right, thanks, Dwayne. Now, the National League wildcard race is officially a two-team race. Why? Well, that's because the Braves have just finished a three-game sweep of the Mets in Atlanta. Mike Piazza pops out to short center field, and the final score from Atlanta this afternoon, 7-2. The Mets scored just 7 runs in the three games, and Atlanta finishes the season with 106 wins. The Mets, they finish with a 5-game losing streak. And how about reading the New York papers tomorrow morning, guys?
Ooh, that'll be ugly. Here's Bonds, and he takes a strike.
Well, they will not be kind. You are in the hunt all year long and had great comeback victories throughout the season, and to end your season on a 5-game losing streak to fall out of it, well, the New York press will not be forgiving.
One pitches to Bonds, and he swings and misses as Wright got one on his hands. Bonds doubled past Helton in the third inning. Knocked in Marvin Bernard. And Wright came back inside and missed 1-2. So it is now a two-team wildcard race. Both the Cubs and Giants leading. Bonds with a mighty swing and a foul back.
Wright standing tight on the hands of Bonds with his fastball. Bonds getting bunched up by it.
Kent on deck. Fifth inning. Outside. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Bonds, it's a high drive in the left center field. Hamilton racing, still racing back. He is not going to get it. It's off the wall. It ricochets back towards the infield. Bonds headed for 3. Bichette can't pick it up. Bonds is at 3rd. Nobody out. And it'll be a triple for Barry Bonds.
Another 2-strike base hit. And another pretty good location pitch that Wright makes early to get burned to the deepest part of the ballpark from Bonds. Ball down and away with movement running away from Bonds, but he clips it, gets backspin on it, and rides it right over the head of Hamilton to the base of the center field wall. And he's got 2 legs of the cycle, a double and a triple. He's sucking for some wind right now. This place is killing him.
Well, the infield is in for Kent, who popped out in the first but hit a deep fly ball to center field in the third, and he grounds this one foul down the left field line. No balls and a strike to Kent. Kent wraps one to left field. Bichette is going back, and this one is up against the wall. Bonds will score easily. Kent will have a double. And it is 4-0. RBI number 126 for Jeff Kent.
It's the middle of the Giants lineup, the heart that's putting up some thunder. A double and a triple from Bonds, a double from Ken, and a home run and a single from Joe Carter, and a double from JT Snow. And here's the mistake. It's just a lazy breaking ball that hangs up there mid-thigh out of the plate. Second breaking ball in a row. The kid sees the AB, and he just smoked it.
Here's Joe Carter. Carter hit a 2-run home run in the third. Ken off a second. And Carter takes low. While this has been going on in St. Louis, Mark McGwire has hit another home run. He now has 70.
70.
Wow. It's just unbelievable.
Here's the 1-0 pitch to Carter, and he hits a little looper in the center field, and that's going to fall. Kent is going to be held up. And Joe Carter with another hit. First and third, nobody out for JT Snow.
I think it's a good job. It's a good play with nobody out to hold the runner at third. I think with one out, maybe Ron Wotus would have sent Jeff Kent. But here, it's no risk. You don't want to risk the possibly having a real big inning by gambling at a play at the plate.
Here's Snow. Here comes Frank Funk. Well, getting back to the 70 home runs by McGuire. About 3 months ago, I turned on the radio and I heard Mike Kruko tell someone, I think he's going to hit 70. Unbelievable. Not unbelievable that that Mike would say that, but unbelievable that McGuire would cooperate.
That's just how many more times can we say unbelievable? I mean, it is. It's just something you could not believe that it could be done. And I don't think that number is going to sink in for a while. In the offseason someday, you reflect upon this season with so many great memories of the 98 campaign. Mark McGuire, 70 home runs, and he's not done yet. He's got more at-bats.
JT Snow with a ringing double into the gap in the third inning. And he takes the fastball up high. Giants have a chance to add on here in the fifth with a 4-0 lead.
I think Mark McGuire's going to take a long vacation when it's all over.
Yep. Hit on the ground to Helton. And Helton checks Kent and throws it away. Kent scores. Carter to third. First and third, nobody out. 5-0. Well, you know who caused that was Jeff Kent.
Well, you're right. He comes down the baseline at third, and he confuses Helton. Helton sees to check him and thinks, I got to get two. And as soon as he throws a hurried throw, Kent scampers in, an easy score. But the wild throw sets up another first and third, no-out situation. And the Giants have a chance to blow this game wide open.
E6. Now he's telling us E6. And here comes Don Baylor. Baylor going to Bruce Dreckman. Don Baylor is going to use his closer right off the bat. And it'll be Dave Veers coming in. We'll be back. Giants have runners at the corners. They've scored twice. It's 5-0. Nobody out. And Veers is coming in. Stay with us. Trivia question. Joe DiMaggio, Eddie Matthews, and Johnny Mize all ended their careers under the same circumstances. How? That's Veers. And you're right about Don Baylor. He's not messing around.
No, he's going to try and win this ballgame, and he knows that this is a chance for the Giants to have a big inning, and he's going to try and put out the fire with one of his most effective relievers, Dave Veers. Good hard fastball slider and a great split finger fastball.
Jerry Shumpert plays second base on the double switch. Shumpert will hit ninth. Aurelia facing Veers, first and third. Nobody out. Aurelia is lined out and he's grounded out. And he hits a hard ground ball foul. Look out, Glenn Kuiper. Is hiding and our camera guy down there. Yeah, I'm doing fine. Oh, and 1-1 to Rich Aurelia. RBI opportunity for Aurelia, who has 49 on the season. 63rd game for Beers. He's got 8 saves, a 287 ERA.
Yeah, anybody has a 287 ERA and pitches a year here has had a great year. The only thing about Beers, too, when he misses, it's usually down below the strike zone, which is where you want to miss. Target around the knees, and if you miss, fall out of the zone low. Good velocity. He's got better velocity now than he's had the last couple of years. It's around 92, 93 miles per hour.
And really, it chases a high fastball. And Richie takes his hat off. Takes a walk. Richie has more meetings with himself than any player on this team.
Yeah, and they're mental wrestling matches. He goes back and forth. And he's hard on himself.
He is. I'm a good player. I'm a bad player. I can't hit. I can hit. 1-2. And he takes a bad pitch low and away. 2 balls and 2 strikes.
The kid from Brooklyn. We have enjoyed his company throughout the season. Very animated. Wears his emotions right on the sleeve. Now, he reminds me a lot of Joel Youngblood.
Yeah, that's a good call. 2-2. Pop back and out of play. You can talk to Richie after the ball game. If he has done a couple of things that haven't been real positive, like if he'll swing and miss at a high fastball to strike out, you might see him afterward and he'll say, you know, I was right on that. Didn't you think I had a real good swing on that? Here's a 2-2 pitch up high, 3-2. And when he says that, then is not the time to be honest.
No, I just agree with him. Maybe the next day before a game, you can open up and say, well, you know, I think you're a little tardy. Might not be the best thing to swing at a ball over your head.
And not that he would fight you if you didn't agree with him. He'd just kind of droop his shoulders. Oh. Payoff pitch to Rich Aurelia. Foul down the right field line.
He's definitely one of the guys you root for. He's animated in his love of this game is very obvious.
He waited a long time to get the nod as the starting shortstop. A walk, and they're loaded for Johnson. And if Rich were to ask, we would tell him that was a good at bat.
Indeed it was. They have a lot of teasers there for Veers who can do it to you. The stuff breaks late. Not easy to milk a walk out of it.
Discover Card will donate $500 to the local chapter of the Make-A-Wish Foundation for each Grand Slam hit in this game. Carter at third, Snow at second, Aurelia at first. Ryan Johnson has walked and he's flied out. And he takes a pitch high, 1 ball and no strikes. This is, in this ballpark, an opportunity the Giants cannot let slip away. They've scored 2, bases loaded, nobody out. And Johnson fouls it off of Manwaring, and Johnson's at bat is particularly important because Rueter is on deck.
And for Brian Johnson, it should be nothing more than a fly ball situation where he's trying to get something up in the strike zone to get lifted into the air to score the run at third. Don't try to do too much. Stay off the ground.
Swing and a miss, 1-2.
Here's his throw for the strikeout. He's got his option here to pitch for the strikeout or the ground ball. Now he's in a 1-2 count. He'll go for the punch-out. And his strikeout pitch is that split-finger fastball. It's nasty.
Johnson has to try to put the ball in play. And he does not. And it's Rueter. Veers, strikes out Johnson, and here's Rueter, who's grounded out and flied out, and it's always a little difficult to put the squeeze play on with the bases loaded, but it is an option. Rueter, bounding ball, could be a pair. Shumpert, and it's dropped, and out is Aurelia, but a run scores. And Shumpert had a little tough time getting that ball out of his glove, and I think it messed with the rhythm that Perez had.
He kind of got caught in between, do I flip or do I try to get my body turned and angled towards the bag and do a little top throw? And he goes with the flip, and this is where he can't dig it out, the high throw there. But Frank Puller, the second base umpire, they called the play correctly. They did get the force because Nephi Perez did hold it long enough. It was in the exchange where he dropped the ball.
Here's Marvin Bernard. Six nothing Giants, and Bernard takes high. It will be an RBI for Rueter, his third of the year. Snow is at third with Rueter at first. Bernard 0 for 1 with two walks. Inside. Two balls and no strikes. Chicago still leading Houston 3-1. That game in the seventh. 3-0. Started off with Bonds tripling. Snow at third. Rueter at first. And Veers deals, and that's a strike. Bernard taking all the way.
As well he should. Let a pitcher dig his own hole.
Bernard into left field. Bichette coming in. He won't get it. Snow scores. It's 7-0. And Marvin Bernard comes through. And here's Bill Miller.
Well, Marvin took the 3-0 pitch, got to a 3-1. He's seen lots of pitches. He knew the movement. Did not try to do too much. Stayed inside out of the swing. And sliced a little dead bird to left field. Keep the inning alive. Two out base hit. He has been something else in two out situations with that bat. Driving in runs.
Bill Miller is 0 for 2 with a walk. And that's a strike right in on the inside corner to Miller. Miller, it's a ground ball at Beers. Snags. Right around the ankle tops, and that'll end the inning. Giants pick up four runs here in the fifth. Rockies coming up 7-0. Denver 7-0 Giants. Now let's check in with the Fox Network Center and our Mark McGuire home run update.
This is a special report from Fox Sports News.
I'm Kevin Frazier. Mark McGuire has just hit his 70th home run.
This has been a special report from Fox Sports News.
Joe Carter with a home run in this game. And the Giants lead it. 7-0. Our Affleck trivia question was, Joe DiMaggio, Eddie Matthews, and Johnny Mine all ended their careers under the same circumstances.
How?
They all ended their careers playing in the World Series. I think that. That's a great question.
Not a bad way to go out. I can say you could put Bob Brindley into that same category, but he didn't get to play in 1989. But he was there in uniform.
Here's Kurt Manwaring to lead it off. Rueter, who had a chance to stay loose in the top of the fifth by running the bases,
throws the first pitch, one ball and no strikes. I assume that's maybe better, Mike, than just sitting there.
Yeah. Well, I can put my name in the same list with Chris Spire and Dave Dravecki. All four of us in 1989 were all on the disabled list. And done. We knew we were leaving baseball after that season. And we had great seats for the World Series is what it all boiled down to.
Van Wering takes a strike. He singled in the second on a hit and run. Kirk with a 245 batting average. Club option on Van Wering. The Rockies have a club option in his contract. And many people feel that the Rockies will not pick it up. Outside. 3-2.
Well, Kurt wants to keep playing.
Yes, he does.
He's got some years left in that body. Good shape.
Hit on the ground. Aurelia can't get it. A base hit for Manuel. Second hit for Kurt. And that'll bring up Terry Shumpert. Shumpert hitting 240. Six hits, 25 at bats. Run a couple of RBIs. Hit 306 at Colorado Springs in 97 games. A utility infielder. And he takes a strike.
Colorado Springs is very much like Denver in that it's a very offensive place to play baseball. So numbers that come out of there are a little inflated. You see a pitcher who's got a low ERA who's coming out of Colorado Springs, you know you've got something.
And Rueter took something off, and it's 0-2.
You can't get too excited about a guy hitting 300 there because it is a little bit unfair because of the altitude.
Problem is if you hit 220, then you're in trouble.
That's right. If you hit 220 in Colorado Springs, start looking for a new job.
0-2 to Shumpert. Chases a high fastball and fouls it back.
Trying to get inside with that four-seamer late in the count. Been a very good pitch for him all year long.
Top of the batting order, Darrell Hamilton on deck. Van Wering at first, nobody out. And Shumpert again stays alive.
I mentioned Kirk Rueter type who has 16 wins and only 183 innings. And of his 32 starts this year, this being his 33rd, he has only gone the seventh inning or more six times. That's not a lot, but what he has done is he has done extremely well the first two times in the lineup. And he's gotten the Giants into the game, the fifth and sixth inning consistently. Tenderness in his elbow, which has really bothered him. Not uncommon injury this time of year for pitchers, what he's had to deal with.
Outside and make it 2-2.
And more than anything else, I think Rueter has proven to the Giants that he could be a big game pitcher. When the adrenaline starts to roll, he can handle himself well.
Shumpert goes down swinging. First strikeout for Rueter, which doesn't come as a surprise. Rueter's not a strikeout pitcher, although once in a while, tally a few.
The finesse guy that makes a living taking the sting out of hitters' bats.
Hamilton grounded out on the first, doubled in the third, and he takes a strike.
There's nothing good about Rueter on a big game like today is that he's so easy going. He's just this big old country boy from Hoyleton, Missouri. And, you know, you put a few quarters in his pocket, and he'll jingle his pockets and sway back and forth and say, oh, shucks.
I mean, after the ballgame yesterday, we were walking back to the hotel, and Richard Reilly and his wife Raquel with Kirk Rueter. And his wife were standing there, and it was like there was no game tomorrow. Rueter's wife, Carla, and
And I mean, you always, I mean, you just naturally look for signs to see, I wonder if he's worried about tomorrow or thinking about it.
Couldn't tell. And there's a base hit off the bat of Darrell Hamilton.
Here's Nafe Perez, who is 0 for 2.
I think because of the track record that Rueter has exhibited throughout the season, Dusty Baker knows that if he gets around the 5th, 6th, 7th inning, that's the time when he's going to start looking at that bullpen. I don't think he has any attention to extend him out here because of his tenderness in that elbow.
So here's Perez, the switch hitter. One down, two on. Rueter had a 1-2-3 inning in the fourth. And there is a strike to Perez. And we're in at second, Hamilton on first. And Perez to the backstop, 1-2. The eighth inning, Chicago leading Houston 3-1. Braves beat the Mets 7-2 in their chances. Down the right field line, that is a fair ball and big time trouble. Joe Carter will dig it out. Two runs will score. And Perez to third with a triple, 7-2.
Well, a much different approach in this at bat than AP Perez's last AP. He had a man at second base, nobody out his last at bat, threw out the left field on a first pitch here. Very content to go the opposite way with the location. And it really proves big for him. He comes up with a triple, knocks in two, and puts his team on the board.
And here's Larry Walker, who rolls it foul. That's a play of the infield back. Walker 1-for-3, single in the first. Hit a high chopper to Aurelia in the third. And he paints him. 0-2. Manny Johnstone getting ready. And tried to do it again, but missed. One ball and two strikes. Dante Bichette on deck. And the 1-2 to Walker, and he hits a ground ball up the middle of base hit. It's 7-3. Walker with a big turn as Bernard will get it back into the infield.
Great two-strike hitting from Larry Walker, National League's leading hitter. He has wrapped up a crown for himself, and it's at bats just like this. Where he stays compact, it's a good pitch to hit on it. A very poor location pitch, a two-strike count from Rueter. Walker capitalizes it. Karnowski wanted to know in a hurry as to whether or not John Johnston is getting close.
4 hits in the inning, 8 now in the game for the Rockies. And Bichette hits a ground ball pass Miller into left field. Bichette has a base hit. Walker to second. 5 hits in the inning. And here's Vinny Castilla.
And Castilla probably the one Rocky who's been quiet throughout the series with just a couple of singles. Mr. Baker knows that he will keep down a powerful bat like Castilla's for so long.
So Dusty has gone to the bullpen. It'll be John Johnstone coming in. Giants are leading 7-3, with the Rockies making a lot of noise.
Who are these people?
Rockies have picked up three runs in this inning on five hits off of Kurt Rueter. There, that has forced Dusty Baker to go into the bullpen. Rueter, no walks, a strikeout, nine hits, three earned runs. And John Johnstone, who had the day off yesterday. And on Friday night, he was sensational. He picked up the win. He went two innings, a walk, a strikeout. And he'll be facing Vinny Castilla.
Johnstone has faced Castilla five times. He's 0 for 5 with three strikeouts.
And he got him to ground out on Friday night. You got to be very careful on that first pitch.
He has not had an at-bat, I believe, this entire series where he's not swung at the first pitch. Incredible.
Johnstone looks to second. Runners go. Swinging a foul back, and Walker had it stolen.
Johnstone will get a little predictable with that head turn. Who's inside? What's going on out there at second base? And Larry Walker's going to pick you clean if you get that opportunity.
Well, Vinny Castilla with a count of no balls and two strikes. And Johnstone deals, and it's way outside. One ball and two strikes.
Still get the day off yesterday, and he has really been one of those pitchers that has benefited from not having to work two consecutive days in a row. So he's out there with his good stuff today. Mr. Baker knows that.
Got him. Oh, two down.
Great two-strike location. The knees low to weight, 93 mile an hour fastball. And this is Payne. Look at the target from Johnson. And he paints it. See ya. Grabs a pine.
Here's Elton. He's single and he's lined out.
He can't breathe a sigh of relief yet. What about this guy? Dangerous hitter, and he has really matured in just 1 year.
A little bit outside to Elton. One ball and no strike. Defensively against Helton. Bernard shading him a little bit to left, and he wraps one into the gap. And there isn't anybody that's going to catch this one. It is gone. And the Rockies are back in it.
Fastball got the fastball and just wore one out.
Abbott fouls it back. He had a good rip. 7-6. Fifth inning. Don't ever think you can get comfortable ever in this park.
No.
And Dusty Baker knows that. Abbott takes high.
You know, I think with what you said before, early in the broadcast, about Don Baylor mentioning on the air that this is probably going to be his last game as a Rocky skipper, I think that may have
got into the Rockies clubhouse and his team is reacting.
Strike two. Abbott, here's the home run.
Trying to give their skipper a pretty good send-off here. And this is one swing of the bat that gets him 3 runs closer.
One and two to Abbott. Got him. That'll end the inning. But 6 runs on the board for the Rockies. We'll head to the sixth inning. Giants still hanging on. They lead 7-6. Laskanik is the new pitcher. And he'll be facing Barry Bonds, and the pitch is high. Well, it's a 7-6 Giants lead. And Bonds pops up the first one into shallow right field. Abbott, Hamilton, and it's Hamilton who'll make the catch. One away. Ryan Johnson sitting next to John Johnston. Here's Jeff Kent. Here's Laskanik, who the Giants saw on Friday night. Roughed him up a bit, a third of an inning, 3 earned runs. Here's Kent, 1-for-3, doubled in a run in his last at bat, and he takes the fastball high.
Maybe we're back in 1995, Kite, the last game of the season when the Giants are playing the Rockies. They jumped out to an 8-2 lead against the Rockies. The Rockies then trying to win a berth in the wild card race for themselves. They had to beat the Giants that final day, and despite getting down 6 runs in that ball game, they rallied back and won the ball game. As you point out, anything can happen in this ball yard.
Kent takes high. Kurt Abbott is now at second base. And it's 3-0 to Jeff Kent, who takes a strike. Carter on deck, 7-6. Kent, pop up, right field, Walker. Glasses down, makes the catch moving towards the line to a win.
Boy, we can a basket catch and snag that thing down. That was not an easy play because of the sun. Or sometimes I think he just Jimmy jacks around with a fly ball just to mess with the fans and the broadcaster.
Yes, he did. Here's Carter. Joe Carter, 3-for-3. 3 RBIs. He scored twice. And Laskanik. And Carter pops it up. Right field. Abbott puts it away. And a 1-2-3 inning. 3 pop-ups for Curtis Laskanik. Bottom of the sixth inning coming up. And we're going to lead it off.
All right, thanks, Dwayne. Well, there was good news in Atlanta earlier, and there's good news in Houston. The Houston Astros, in the bottom of the eighth inning, had already scored 1 run to make it 3-2. And then with 2 outs, Sean Berry hit a bloop. Jeff Blauser went back. Lance Johnson went in, and the ball falls, and Jeff Bagwell running all the way would hesitate a little bit. Watch where Blauser's throw goes. Bagwell scores all the way from first. That coming with 2 outs, Berry ends up at second, and it is a 3-3 game, bottom of the eighth in Houston. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Glenn. And Curtis Goodwin is the pinch hitter facing John Johnstone here in the sixth inning. And Goodwin fouls it back.
This usually means that when they pinch hit for Manware in this slot, the pitcher spot was in the ninth spot. They're going to go ahead and put Jeff Reed in the ballgame, and he'll be on deck. He hasn't come out on next circle yet. But I would imagine if Johnston was going to face 3 left-handed hitters here in the city, Goodwin, Reed, and Darrell Hamilton.
And it's a strike to Goodwin, and it's 1-2. Miller, who was playing in, looking for the bunt. Now we'll move back. And that pitch is high. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Curtis Goodwin hitting 247. terrific speed. If you're on the infield, you know what you have to do, and that's make the play very quickly. And it's 3-2.
With all the lefties, left hand is stacking up in this inning. Dusty Baker has Rich Rodriguez now starting to get loose in the bullpen. He's got two lefties in the pen, Orban and Rodriguez.
And Goodwin hits one in the air. But it could be tough. Bernard, Bonds, and it's Bonds who sneaks in at the very end as he cuts between Aurelia and Bernard to make the catch. This is Edgar Clemente. Clemente started in right field on Friday night as he takes a strike. Overall hitting 313. Larry Walker pinch hit on Friday night. And another strike, and it's 0-2. Fans were hoping that Walker would very kindly take 3 days off, but it didn't happen. The 0-2 pitch, and it's way up high.
Got it underneath that slider just a bit, pushed it out. Did not get on top of it. When he gets on top of it, he gets downward break on it. When he doesn't, he pushes it and slides across.
And in and out of the glove of Brian Johnson. 1-2. Hamilton on deck. And that's in the center field. Marco Bernard broke back. Now he's racing in, and he won't get it.
Now, because there's so much area in the outfield, it's just unforgivable if you break the wrong way initially off the ball. Ball not hit well. Clemente with good power. And I think Bernard expected more of that. That back step off his initial go allowed that ball to drop.
And Dusty Baker is coming out, and this is the replay.
Maybe Carl Lewis might have enough speed to catch up to something like that. For mere mortals, not possible.
Dusty Baker in conversation with Bruce Dreckman. Stan Javier is running out to the outfield, and looks like we'll have a double switch, so we'll step aside with Rich Rodriguez coming in. It's 7-6. Bottom of the sixth inning, Giants leading 7-6. Joe Carter has come out of the game on a double switch. And our Discover Card payback playback is Joe Carter in this ball game. Joe, 3-for-4 with a 2-run home run. He also has another RBI, and he leaves the field. And what the Giants are hoping is not his last game. And that is our Discover Card payback playback. Discover Card, it turns to Discover.
Fans of Coors Field twice gave Joe Carter a couple of nice ovations. Appreciation of his career.
Whoever discovered Joe Carter in the early 80s, did good. Rich Rodriguez facing Hamilton. He's 2-for-3. And that pitch is a strike. It's been a busy weekend for Rich Rodriguez. Pitched on Friday. 2/3 of an inning. Yesterday pitched 2 innings. 2 perfect innings.
We asked him if it was a problem getting it up again today. He said, not at all. This is the time of year you don't even think about that.
Hamilton pokes it out of play. It's 0-2.
And he's backing it up. He's got another 93 mile an hour fastball here today.
Stan Javier is now in center field, moving from center to right is Marvin Bernard. So it's Bonds, Javier, and Bernard in the outfield. 7-6, Giants, bottom of the sixth. Billy Wagner is on to pitch in Houston. A tie game in the ninth. 0-2 to Hamilton. And Hamilton, like he can do and just aggravate you, just barely stays alive.
Yeah, good hard slider, good location. And that was an emergency swing. Hamilton's swing is really small. Two strikes, and he hit. It's almost like he's playing pepper. There's not much lower body in the swing whatsoever. And he can really be quick and stay alive a lot of counts because of that quickness.
And the 0-2 pitch with the runner going. Swinging a line drive. Snow's got it! And he steps on the bag! And Hamilton flips the batting helmet down, and Snow saves the day. Boy, how things can turn in a hurry. We'll head to the seventh. Giants hanging on.
Seven Colorado six as we head to the top of the seventh. It's time now as Hoover presents our pickup of the game. What do you think? With one out, man at first base. Giants leading by a run. A rocket off the bat of Darrell Hamilton goes into the glove of JT Snow. He snags it. He steps on the bag and doubles up at guard Clemente, and that kills the inning. And that is our Hoover pickup of the game. Hoover, nobody does it like you.
And here's Chuck McElroy into pitch facing JT Snow, who is batting left-handed against McElroy, and the pitch is low, 1-0. Jeff Reed is in to do the catching, and Snow fouls it out of play.
Remember, JT Snow, who's had what now, his third at bat against lefties, maybe four at most. He's hanging in there pretty good. That front side's pretty solid.
Seventy-eighth appearance for McElroy. Snow hits it hard, and Helton backhands it, and he'll go to the bag. So Helton says, touche.
Nonetheless, a pretty solid AP for JT. He's got to feel good about that right there. McElroy, a tough lefty, hung in there on the breaking ball, and it's a one-hop seed right to Helton, who does a good backhand stab, and he takes it himself.
Rich Aurelia. Aurelia, 0-2 with a walk. Nobody on, one out. Seventh inning. And there's a strike. Last time Giants saw McElroy, he gave up a three-run home run to Bonds. The Giants only win against the Rockies. The last trip into three count. One ball and one strike. And a bounding ball to Nafy Perez. And he takes a couple of skips to first and throws. Two away. Now they're heading into the bottom of the ninth inning in Houston. And it's a 3-3 tie. Here's Brian Johnson.
You didn't think it was going to be something that didn't have any drama to it, did you?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, this is 1998.
Johnson has walked, he's flied out and struck out. And he's got a base hit to left field. And Stan Javier gets to hit. Two out single. Javier, who came in on the double switch, will bat for the first time.
Javier has had his problems lifetime against McElroy, 0-6 with a couple of punch outs.
Right up the middle, and that'll be a base hit. Brian Johnson will put the brakes on. And Stan Javier is hot, folks. He had two home runs yesterday. He had three hits.
And that's good news in the long scheme of things as well, because Javier is a streak hitter.
home runs yesterday for Stan Javier.
Opposite field to left field from the left side. He sliced it out. And then later on in the ballgame, gets something middle in. Right at the belt, and he puts one out to right center. This was a bomb. Came into the game with two home runs and left the game with four.
Pinch runner for Brian Johnson. It'll be Wilson Delgado. Frank Funk out to talk to Chuck McElroy. So Brad Ausmus will be the first hitter for Houston in the ninth. Facing Rod Beck. Marvin Bernard, who had a two-out base hit his last time up, to knock in a run. And that fastball is high. Pedro Estacio in the bullpen.
Estacio, who has pitched out of relief in his career, so not a role he's unfamiliar with.
Strike to Bernard.
And for Don Baylor, true to his word, said he, before the game, that he would use Estacio.
And that's high. 2-1.
I think he's given Estacio a lot of time to get loose in the city, get to Jeff Kent. I think McElroy's going to face the next three hitters if the inning goes that far.
And a strike to Bernard, and that evens the count. Delgado at second with Javier at first. Way outside in a full count.
Well, that's a significant pitch because now with two outs and a 3-2 count, if the ball finds a gap here, it'll feed the bases. Get good speed with Delgado and Javier on the tracks.
See what McElroy does. Runners go. Bernard pops it down the left field line out of play. Dusty Baker. Just a weekend where the Giants knew they had to score a lot of runs. You always have to. Runners go. Bernard hits another one foul. Look out, Ron Otis. He got clipped yesterday on a throw. The guys are giving him a hard time this morning.
They were. He was taking some shots from his team. Yesterday, he was at third base in his coaching box position, and the ball got through Castilla's legs and hit him right in the jaw.
Runners go. High. They're loaded. Bill Miller. Two outs in Houston. And Rod Beck facing Greg Biggio.
Now McElroy's really been a pitcher who got very hot in the earliest part of the season but has been cold lately. And we saw this with Baylor before. When he's cold, like he is right now, he did not show well the first AB, he replaces him.
And Estacio is going to come in. So it'll be Miller against Estacio. Taking his warm-up pitches, he'll be facing Bill Miller. Estacio can be tough.
Well, he can be. He's got good live arm. Doesn't always have the best of command with it. Low three quarters release, kind of a slinger. And what we had thought, we'd see McElroy at least get through the line to Bonds. But as I mentioned earlier this year, we saw a same situation with McElroy coming in, and he was not throwing to the liking of Don Baylor. But Don Baylor wasted no time. He gave him one hitter, and he took him out of the ballgame. And this is exactly what he did today. Did not like what he saw. He's going to Estacio. Stasso has faced Miller eight times in his career. Miller 1-for-8. That hit, however, was a home run.
In Houston, Beck strikes out Biggio, so they're going to extra innings. Beautiful day. Shadow starting to creep into the playing area. Giants just clinging on to a one-run lead, which in this part isn't enough. Miller hit a grand slam in the last homestand. And the pitch to Bill Miller is in the dirt. One ball in your stand. Big curveball.
Big slurry breaker. His best pitch is his fastball. I don't even know why he's jimmy jacking around with that big slow curveball.
Miller bounding ball to second, where Abbott has it, and that will end the inning. Estacio gets the ground ball. So the Giants will strand 3-10 in the game. Tickets, individual game tickets for division series playoff games, which would take place next Saturday and Sunday at 3 Comp Park, are now on sale. If the Giants win the wild card race, they host the Atlanta Braves. That would be Saturday and Sunday, October 33rd and October 4th at 3 Comp. To secure your tickets, call 510-762-BALL or stop by the Giants dugout store, 3 Comp Park ticket office, or any Bass ticket center locations. All tickets, of course, run play games are refundable. The 3 Comp Park ticket office will be open on Saturday, and we'd like to remind you that really the way to do it is stop by the dugout stores or the ticket office at the ballpark or the Bass ticket centers. Otherwise, you can avoid waiting in the lines to pick up your tickets on game day. Here's Nafe Perez facing Rich Rodriguez. Perez on the ground, in the hole. Aurelia with a long throw, off line. Perez aboard. That'll be a base hit. To 364.
Rodriguez has won the first two rounds of this series facing Walker with strikeouts.
And Walker showed bunt. I wouldn't be fooled by that, however.
No. I don't think Rich Rodriguez is going to take the bait either and lay a fastball in there. David Perez not a big stealing threat. He's only got 5 of the year. He's been thrown out 6 times.
There's a strike. On deck, Bichette. A one-run lead for the Giants. Good speed at first. And Walker swings and misses.
Good.
It's 1-2.
That's a good hard slider right there. Cut that thing right in there. Pretty much the same location he got him on the strikeout with last night.
Down and away, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Rodriguez will take a walk off the back of the mound.
Well, the first night he struck him out with a slider. The next night, or yesterday rather, he struck him out with a fastball. So here he is, another 2-strike situation. Yesterday, Walker surprisingly was guessing breaking ball in a 2-strike count, not trying to protect, and he guessed wrong, and Rodriguez won the war.
go to first, and back is correct. All the runs for the Rockies scored in the fifth, a 6-5. They're going to the bottom of the 10th in Houston. It's 3-3.
Times in the at-bats that Rodriguez has had with Walker that he's got to pitch above the belt.
Good look at the crowd. 48,000. 5-24. Walker against Rich Rodriguez. Kent. To Aurelia. Not in time.
Kind of a tough play for Rich Aurelia. Got a changeup from Jeff Kent on the throw to second base. And he had to make sure that he stayed in the bag to get the lead out. Steve Baker talking to Bruce Dreck, who played umpire. It'll be a double switch and new pitcher.
Charlie Hayes looks like he's coming into the game. And it'll be Julian Tavares coming in. So Dusty Baker making some more changes. And right now the Giants hanging on. They lead 7-6. We'll be back. His way to Tavares. Tavares pitched on Friday. Pitched the third of an inning. Gave up a run. The day off yesterday, and he'll be facing Dante Bichette with Walker at first base.
Well, he faced Tavares on Friday night and singled, so Tavares against Bichette lifetime. Bichette 3-for-7 with a triple and a couple of singles. Mr. Baker banking on the fact that he could get a ground ball from Tavares and get out of the inning.
Houston, Derek Bell has just singled. And he's on first base with one out. And Jeff Bagwell at the plate. Bagwell hit him a home run off of Beck in the ninth inning. And the game yesterday. Charlie Hayes in at third. He'll hit in the fifth spot. And the matchup now. Tavares and Bichette. And a soft toss to first. Walker, who can be crafty at first, you got to watch him. He's stolen 14 bags. He tried to steal third earlier in the game. And Bichette. Off his fist, chops it foul off his foot, off his fist, off his foot. What else did it hit?
Feet, fist, fingers, feet, five, four, thumb.
Guys are hoping that it hadn't hit off his foot.
You know, I don't think there's a pitch that can be thrown that Bichette feels he can't hit.
Yeah, he feels he can hit it somewhere.
If he doesn't swing at that pitch and make contact, it hits him in the stomach.
Castillo waiting on deck. 7-6 Giants. Bichette 1-for-3. He's singled in the fifth. Popped him up. JT Snow fighting the sun. Near the dugout, makes the catch. Two down here in the seventh.
Turn one of those big hitters back to the bat rack after an AB and get it out, you've dodged a bullet. so tough in this ballpark.
Castilla is grounded out twice and he struck out. And throw to first, Walker back. Say it again. Be careful on the first pitch.
Extended through a fastball that is laid up there on a tee. Ouch.
Helton hits a ground ball to Rich Aurelia near the bag. He will throw him out. And that'll end the inning. Two runs. 8-7 Rockies. Barry Bonds will lead it off.
Game's tied. Late the game, one of the 11th.
Low to snow, isn't it the way it's supposed to be?
It's exactly the way it's supposed to be. This wild card race has certainly been something to follow. Neither team is disappointed. So far.
Low to snow, 2-0. JT has doubled in four trips to the plate. He knocked in a run on a fielder's choice in the fifth. A hit taken away from him in the seventh as he hit a ball down the line that Helton dove and made a play on. Here he'd like to take advantage of that hole between first and second. And he hits one to left field. Bichette going back. He's got a beat on it and he makes the catch.
Well, right now, Stasso's not fooling anybody. For the Giants pitch on the Kid home run.
Now here's Rich Aurelia with two down. Richie is 0 for 3. Walked in the fifth inning. Aurelia kind of squinting a little bit. I'm talking about how difficult it is right now to see. And the first pitch is a breaking ball that misses. Kent didn't have much of a problem.
He looked in like he knew it was coming.
One ball and no strike. Brent Maine is on deck, and now Aurelia steps out. With a short lead. Aurelia pops one in the left center field. Hamilton coming in. Bichette coming in, and it's Hamilton who'll make the catch. Inning over. Kent's home run ties it. Bottom of the eighth coming up. Giants 8, Rockies 8. Bye-bye, baby. Wild card race. They host a division series next Saturday and Sunday, October 3rd and 4th, and that'll happen right at Three Count Park. You can secure your tickets now by calling 510-762-BALL. And we really encourage you to We stop by the Giants dugout store, 3-Com Park ticket office, or any Bass Ticket Center location. Get those tickets in your hand. Tavares facing Abbott, and there's a strike. Abbott struck out as a pinch hitter in the fifth inning. And that pitch is outside. One ball and one strike. On deck, Reed. And then the pitcher's spot. Swing and a miss. One ball and two strikes.
That home run that Tavares gave up to Vinny Castilla, just the fifth home run he's given up all year in 84 plus innings. Not an easy guy to take deep, but he got one up to Castilla's happy zone. That's been the difference.
And that pitch is high to Abbott. Two balls, two strikes. Tavares standing on the mound, now gets the sign and throws. And Abbott hits a ground ball to Charlie Hayes, who throws in time. Trying to kind of cut that on the heel of his glove, but he made the play, one down. And here's Reed. For the first time, hitting 291, 9 home runs, 39 RBIs, and he hits a sharp ground ball to Rich Aurelia. He has it. He flips it to Snow, two away. Jason Bates will be the pinch hitter.
Bars back down in the lower part of the strike zone. The result, ground balls.
Out of the game. Bates, a switch hitter, batting 178. And the first pitch is away. Ball and no strikes to Jason Bates.
Giants guarding the line with Hayes and Snow. First and third.
In the shadows in left field. And the 2-0 pitch to Bates. And he goes to left field, and that'll be a base hit. Bonds will move over and get it off. And Bates is aboard with two down. This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the San Francisco Giants and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of the San Francisco Giants. Here's Hamilton. Hamilton hit a line drive in his last at bat that Snow caught and then stepped on the bag for a double play. It was a fantastic catch by Snow. And he hits a shot right at Aurelia. And Hamilton has had two taken away from him, and that will end the inning. And no smiles this time from Hambone. Ninth inning coming up is tied. 12 hits and no errors for the Giants. 8 runs, 14 hits, and the Rockies have committed an error. Brent Maine will lead it off for the Giants here in the ninth. Jerry DePoto will be the new Rockies pitcher. DePoto worked on Friday night, went 2 innings, gave up 5 hits and 2 runs. He threw 40 pitches. And Jason Bates will go in to play second base. They're in the bottom of the 11th inning in Houston, 3-3. But Giants Now going to try to go after Jerry DePoto.
And DePoto's been the closest thing to a closer that the Rockies have had. He leads the team in saves with 19. Good hard slider, good fastball. Get up there mid-90s. 70 innings, he has struck out 49. He's walked 25 and given him 61 hits.
And here's Brent May. Main batting for the first time. Hitting 268, and he takes a fastball for a strike. Three home runs, 32 RBIs for Brent Main. Poto pitching out of the stretch. And it's low. Stan Javier on deck. Stan waiting, watching Maine. And Maynard hits a ground ball to the first baseman off and one down. And here's Javier. Javier singled in the seventh inning. Game yesterday comes back, gets in this game on a double switch, and here's the pitch, and he drives it into center field. Hamilton going back, but he's got room. Two down.
Hamilton has been playing a very shallow set throughout most of the series. The score tied late in the game and not wanting to give him an extra base hit is really backed up, and that pre-pitch positioning right there paid off there. An easy play for him.
Here's Marvin Bernard. Bernard has reached first base the last four times. Stands in here with two outs. And he fouls it back. In Houston, Carl Everett has just tripled over the head of Derek Bell in right field. Make it over the head of Sammy Sosa in right field. And the Astros have a runner at third with one out. Here's Bernard. Blowing away.
Shadows continuing to be a problem here. Not an easy at bat. Pick the ball up. It's a bright ball, and then it disappears into the shadow.
And Bernard swings through that fastball. It's 1-2.
I think it may have been a slider type. It's a money pitch for DePoto that he likes to go after lefties with. It's got straight downward break, as you see Rob did warming up now for the Giants. When DePoto gets you to two strike, that's the pitch he likes to finish you off with. And when he misses, it's always in the base of the strike zone.
1-2 pitch to the second baseman, Bates. And that will end the inning. 1-2-3 inning for Jerry DePoto. Ninth inning coming up. Perez, Walker, Bichette. This game is tied. Pitch to Perez, and he hits a high drive to right field. Uh-oh. Gone. And the game is over, and they're headed to Chicago. And they'll take down the classic they had in the clubhouse, which was there for the celebration. And the Giants lose it in the ninth. A Nathan Perez home run. One more game, and it'll be in Chicago tomorrow. Dusty Baker coming out. He'll shake hands with Frank Funk. Jackie Moore coming over. And the wild card race ends up in a tie. And for now, we'll step aside. 9-8 is the final. Stay with us. We'll have more right after this.